No, it didn't take me one time. I'll be honest with you. It took me two. Okay? Two flips. Just kidding. It didn't take me two. It took me a lot more than that, but that's okay. All right, so we're going to head to French Creek Outfitters. We're going to see if they let me film in there. I don't think they will because they're weird like that sometimes. I don't know. But I'm going to see what's there. Probably buy some Yigs because I need some. Check out the fluoro selection because I need some of that too. And we'll see what else we can get into while we're there. Who knows? All right, we're here at French Creek, somewhere over there. Let's see what we can get into, I guess. I guess we'll go in and check stuff out. It's always good coming here, like on one of the busiest days ever. Great kayak selection here, from Jackson to Wilde to Hobie. Vibe, Perception, all brands, all different levels of, you know, kayaks. They have the Kusa FD here. Boat looks pretty legit. It's interesting, the actual flex drive of it though, and how you can pick it up and put it down, and how it bounces back up when you hit something. So it'll be interesting to see if I ever get to actually use one. The other thing that I just checked out was the Bonafide SS-127. Hold on. Checked out the Bonafide SS-127. Slick looking boat, especially in the cool hand blue. It's really tempting. That boat is really tempting. The seat looks great. The storage looks great. The mon pod in the middle, great idea. The height of it, the stability, everything I've seen, everything I've read, is pushing me towards that boat. There's a couple other boats I want to try before I move into another boat. I love my Old Town Predator though. I do. That thing's caught me a lot of fish. It's seen a lot of slime. Lots of work put into that boat. So I guess we'll see coming up this year where I end up. That's enough of that. Bought some stuff and talked to some people about some boats and reviewed some boats, looked over some things, and my car's locked still, even though I pressed the button. There we go. And I'll see you guys all at home in 3, 2, 1. Okay, here we go. We're gonna finally test the Bass Mafia box versus the Plano 3700 series waterproof box. Now, both of them are supposed to be waterproof, but we're gonna find out which one actually is, or if they both are, or if they're both not. Now I've had problems with the 3700 with water getting in there after I put a lure that I've used in it and having to leave it open and let it dry because it's pretty airtight. So that one I know I'm pretty sure is 100% waterproof. Now the Bass Mafia box I'm not sure about because I've heard conflicting reports on if it's waterproof or not and if the latches stay latched. So we're gonna do that now and find out if it's actually waterproof. So I'm gonna do a couple tests to hopefully demonstrate whether it's waterproof or not, and hopefully you guys like it. All right, we're gonna compare this guy to this guy. We're gonna do three tests. We're gonna do a splash test, we're gonna do a dunk test, and then we're gonna do a durability test. What I'm gonna call it. To save money, I might not even do it because this thing's expensive. Like, really expensive for a tackle box. And these are not, so that's why I have these, and that's why I only have one of these. I have four of these and one of these for a reason, because this one is almost 40 bucks, or it's $36.99 or something like that, retails for. I don't know, I'll put it in the actual, like right here, the actual price. But yeah, let's compare to see if the expensive one is better in any way than this cheap one, or if the cheap one is better in any way than the expensive one. So let's go over the things that I already like. One, the construction of this feels solid. Like, it feels like it's gonna stand up to anything
It's tough. It doesn't bend. Like, when you squeeze this one, like, you can feel the plastic bend. When you squeeze this one, it doesn't, nothing moves. Nothing at all. So, I mean, you can, like, kind of, you know, squeeze this one a little bit, I guess. So, but yeah, I already like the durability feel of it. I already like the feel of this one more than the Plano. So props to Bass Mafia on that. They got a point for that one. So ding, Bass Mafia 1 point, Plano none. All right, so highly scientific test in our super high-tech test tank over here, aka this old Coleman cooler. I got a GoPro in there. We're gonna dunk them now. So this is the dunk test. I'm literally just gonna submerge them for like 15 seconds. We'll pull them out. I'm gonna put a paper towel inside each of them. And if that paper towel's wet, then that'll tell me, that'll help indicate if that, if water got in it. So here goes nothing. All right, up first is the Plano 3700 series waterproof box. Let's dunk away. This is boring, I know. But someone's got to do it. Oh, and there goes the GoPro. I'm gonna open it now. See if the paper towel is dry. It's dry. The paper towel is dry. So no water in here, just on the outside. No water inside the box, which is its job. That's what it's supposed to do. So round two. Let's see if the other one is waterproof as well. But now it's time for the Bass Mafia box to take a dip. Paper towel inside of it, fresh one, totally different from the one in that one. So let's see if how waterproof this is. Now, the only thing that's concerning me is that the latches on that seem to pull it together, whereas this one doesn't seem to pull it together as much, but I think there's still pretty good seal on it because you can hear the air come out when you pull it down. So I guess we'll see. Again, I know, really boring. But someone's gotta do it. No air bubble coming out of it, which is good. It means it should be sealed. Moment of truth. Here we go. Dry, totally dry. Nothing inside this. Stopped at the O-ring like it's supposed to, and yeah, we're good. Dry. The inside of this box is dry. There's the paper towel that I just got wet with my hands. So they both passed the dunk test with flying colors, so both of them get a point, so that's two for Bass Mafia and one for Plano. I know, I changed my outfit a little bit because now the real experimentation begins, I guess you could say. A true scientist gets involved to the fullest with his experiment and dives deeply into his hypothesis and makes sure it's absolutely correct, which that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna dive headfirst into this and I'm going to be the splash test. I'm doing this, it's like 45 degrees, it's cold, it's windy, and I'm stupid, this is dumb. Splash test number one, Bass Mafia, ready, go. Yep, no water in here. Splash test number two, Plano 3700 series waterproof. Go. Moment of truth. Waterproof. Weird. They're both advertised as waterproof and they're actually waterproof. Cool.
All right, so we've done the dunk test, which Bass Mafia succeeded in that as well as the Plano. We did like the general review, which Bass Mafia got a point for that, and Plano got no points for that. So it is 3-2 Bass Mafia with one test to go, and that's the durability test. And the durability test is gonna set them apart, I think. Because like I said in that first part, just the general feel and the construction of it just feels better. So let's get back to science and sciencing and durability test coming up in 3-2.
Durability test. I'm gonna run it over with my car. So, as you just saw, this got run over by a car. And, totally fine. That's insane. I think that just makes it worth every single penny. It's expensive, but now it's officially worth it to me. So, I was really nervous about that breaking, but no cracks. Some scuffs on the bottom, but that's about it. No major structural damage. Crazy, that's insane.
That's definitely a point for the Bass Mafia because that Plano box wouldn't survive that at all. Not even close. I don't think it wouldn't be, it's not even fair on that one. So Bass Mafia 4, Plano waterproof 2, but the point of this was to see which one's more waterproof than the other. They're both waterproof. So they both win on that account. Nothing inside them got wet. So if you're a kayak fisherman like me, both of them are fine. But if you want something rugged, durable, that's never gonna break, that you can run over with a freaking car, say you leave it out and you accidentally run it over, nothing inside of it will be damaged because it just survived that. That's insane. I'm still baffled by that. That's crazy. Before I go, and before I do my sign off, I gotta give away this lucky tackle box. So. Two or three videos ago, I said, you know, comment, like, subscribe, share it with a friend, my channel, and I'd give away a lucky tackle box to someone in the comment section. I did a random comment generator. The winner is Yakfish Derp. Has been seen in my videos. It randomly popped up his name. I'm very surprised. I didn't want him to win, but he did anyway. So he'll be getting this lucky tackle box from courtesy of me. So congrats Derp, I know. Go check out his channel, he'll be linked below. So if you have the means to afford a Bass Mafia box, do it because that's worth every single penny in my opinion. The box was performed flawlessly, waterproof, durable, it feels good in your hands, it's heavy, it's overall just a really good tackle box. So if you're looking for a new tackle solution, consider the Bass Mafia box. I know it's expensive, but consider it. So anyways, check out the rest of my channel. Thanks for watching this video. Like, subscribe, comment, report, delete. I don't care. Do something. Just get here and watch my videos. Have some fun. And give me some suggestions for new videos. Things are starting to warm up. Snow's starting to melt. So you'll see some fishing videos really soon. Check out my Instagram because you'll see even more photos and videos from that. Thanks, and I will see you guys in the next video.